Trust your first impression. What do you see down there?
I'm by a beach again.
I'm by a beach. Mm-hmm. Tell me about that beach.
I'm standing in front of this ocean.
Mm-hmm.
I'm upset about something.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So let's see what you're upset about. I want you to tell me a little bit about you. Look down at your feet. Can you see your feet?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Are you male or female?
I'm a female.
Mm-hmm. And how old do you feel there?
I'm about 22.
Mm-hmm. Can you see what you look like?
I'm very beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Very long black hair.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about your features.
I seem to be Middle Eastern.
Mm-hmm. How are you dressed?
I'm wearing a long, flowy, looks like pants, but like a skirt at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
It's closed at the ankles. It's gold colored.
Mm-hmm. What else?
I'm wearing a gold headband on my head.
Mm-hmm.
And a gold and black vest, like.
Do you see any jewelry on yourself?
No.
Mm-hmm.
My sandals are gold.
Where are you standing?
I'm standing in front of the beach.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm upset.
So let's go within and find out what it is that you're upset at. Trust your first impression. What's going on?
Somebody left me.
Mm. Tell me more about that. Tell me what happened.
He was We were supposed to be married.
Mm-hmm.
And he seems to have just left.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm by the beach trying to figure out if he's coming back or what.
Mm-hmm. Are you by yourself there?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So let's go back in time. I want you to close that scene and go back in time to see what was happening. Go to the most relevant time that explains what happened. Be there now. Where are you?
I'm in a house.
Mm-hmm.
A big house.
Mm-hmm.
The tiles are black and white. But this is his family's house. And they don't seem to like me much.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about his family. Who are they? Are they of much importance?
they don't seem to be royalty,
mm-hmm.
and yet they are comfortable.
Mm-hmm. How about you?
I'm in that same category.
Mm-hmm.
Like we're all from the same village or something.
Mm-hmm. So tell me what's happening. Who's there with you?
His mother and two sisters. Two of his sisters.
Mm-hmm. And how is it that you're there? Have you been invited to be there?
He led me there.
Mm-hmm.
To introduce me.
Mm-hmm. Is he with you?
I sense he's with me, but I don't see him.
Okay. So what happens next?
They're not happy.
Mm-hmm.
They're not happy that I'm there.
What are they saying?
That I'm not the one they want for him.
Tell me how that makes you feel.
I'm stunned. That's not what I expected.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm angry.
What do you say?
I don't say anything.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just standing and they're waiting for me to leave.
Mm-hmm. I want you to take a good look at these three women. Look into their eyes. The eyes are the window to the soul. See if you recognize any of those women.
No.
Okay. So what happens next?
I walk out. And that's when I find myself by the beach.
Mm-hmm.
But now I realize he left because they don't want him for me.
Mm-hmm.
And rather than tell me, he left.
Mm-hmm. So what happens next?
I'm just walking back and forth by this beach, not knowing what to do. And it's getting dark.
Mm-hmm. So I want you to move forward now to another time in that same lifetime, a time that's important. Where are you?
I'm at a party.
Mm-hmm.
Celebration.
Mm-hmm. How old are you there now?
35.
Mm-hmm. What are you celebrating?
It's a wedding.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's my cousin's wedding.
Mm-hmm. Who are you with there?
I'm by myself.
Mm-hmm. You didn't marry?
No.
Look at your appearance. How do you look?
I'm wearing a long red dress. Mm-hmm. Everyone's dancing.
Mm-hmm. How are you feeling there?
Out of place.
Mm-hmm. What thoughts are going through your mind?
I shouldn't be there. I don't have an escort. I don't have anybody with me. Mm-hmm. But I have to be there.
Why do you have to be there?
It's family. Mm-hmm.
Connect with the people around you. What are they saying about you?
I feel like they kind of feel sorry for me. Mm-hmm. They're kind of whispering about my situation.
How does that make you feel?
Somehow, I'm not too bothered by it. Mm-hmm. It's okay. I've accepted it. Mm-hmm. I know I have to be there.
All right. Is there anything else from that scene that's important? Look around.
There's a gentleman across the room. Mm-hmm. Who seems to be looking at me. Mm-hmm. But I'm trying to avoid his stare.
So what happens next?
I'm trying to leave before he approaches me. Mm-hmm.
Tell me more.
He approaches me. He's reaching his hand out. And I excuse myself to leave.
How does that make you feel?
Relieved.
Mm-hmm. Tell me why.
Because I don't want to get to know anyone. I don't want to go through the fatigue of getting to know anyone.
Mm-hmm. All right. What is it that they call you by name?
Michelle.
Michelle. Mm-hmm. So, Michelle, I'd like you to close that scene and let's move ahead to another important scene in that lifetime. Just drift and flow through time and space. Where are you?
I'm in my house. Mm-hmm.
Tell me about your house. What does it look like?
It's a nice house. It's not big. Mm-hmm. I live there with my husband. Mm.
Tell me about your husband. When did you meet him?
seem to have met him at a park.
Very good. How do you feel about this man?
He's a strong person that I can rely on. He's a good husband. We have 2 children.
Tell me more.
They're happy children. A boy and a girl.
How old are they now?
The boy is 5. The girl is 7. And I'm happy and content.
Very good. What else do you see from that scene?
I'm cooking. The house is just lovely.
What are you cooking on?
I'm in front of a stove. Cooking a large pan. And I'm happily cooking.
Very good. So let's close that scene now. Close it and let's drift and float to another important scene. Where are you?
I'm at a department store. But
tell me more.
I meet the person who left.
You meet the same man?
The same man whose family
rejected you?
Didn't want me.
How old are you now?
Like 43?
What happens with this man?
He seems shocked to see me.
Why is that?
And happy at the same time. And I'm happy to see him as well.
What feelings are you having?
I'm happy to see him, but I'm detached. I'm just happy to see him and catching up in our lives. He never married. And I'm happy to be married. I end the conversation. I don't want to continue.
So what happens next?
I continue what I came to shop for. And I feel him kind of following me around. He seems to be calling me, but I'm not answering. I just want to get home to my family.
Very good. Let's close that scene and let's move now to another important time in that same lifetime. Let's move forward. Where are you?
I'm at a funeral.
Mm-hmm.
My husband passed away.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
It's hard for me to believe. I'm standing in front of his coffin. With the two children.
How old do you feel there?
I'm like 50.
Mm-hmm.
But my children are still little.
Mm-hmm.
It's like they're still 5 and 7.
Mm-hmm.
And there aren't too many people around. But I feel strong. I feel very strong. He passed away loving me.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything else from that scene that's important?
I didn't attend the burial. I walked away with the two children, just letting the people who are there to do the rest.
Mm-hmm. Very good. All right, so let's close that scene and now let's go to the last day of your life in that lifetime. Move forward to the last day. Tell me where you are.
I'm on a bed.
Mm-hmm.
I don't feel any pain or anything.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel?
I'm 60.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm happy. I'm content. I know I'm leaving.
Mm-hmm. Are you by yourself or is somebody with you?
Those two children. My two children. But they didn't grow. Mm-hmm. They're still 5 and 7.
Mm-hmm.
And they understand.
So I want you to go now to the last breath. Take your last breath. And I want you to tell me what happens after you leave your body.
I see my body.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just walking away.
Mm-hmm. Where do you go, Michelle?
I'm just walking and it's dark.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm walking with a purpose. I keep looking back a little at my body.
Mm-hmm.
But it's getting further and further. I'm still walking in this darkness.
So as you're walking there, tell me, you can fast forward to the moment when something happens.
There are a bunch of people.
Describe them for me.
There's a woman with a veil, as if she were waiting for me. She's happy to see me.
Who is this woman?
I don't know who she is, but she knows me.
What does she tell you?
She's not saying anything. She's smiling. And I'm walking towards her. And now she's hugging me.
So connect with her telepathically. Let's find out who she is.
She's Mother Mary. I'm like her child. It's like I was away and she's waiting for me and she's happy that I'm back. There are a lot of people there too.
Let's find out who they are. Connect with them.
Some of them don't look... They look like little robots. Children robots.
Describe them.
They have a tin body.
A tin body.
Like a tin, gold color. Like a robot. Robots. But they're happy to see me too. But they're like children.
Connect with them and see who they are.
They said they're here to welcome me. They're all here to welcome me.
What happens next?
Everyone around looks golden, except for Mother Mary. She's in blue with the veil. And she's the only one who looks like a person, though. Everybody else seems... look like robots.
What do you look like?
I don't seem to have a body. I know I'm there, but... I don't see my body.
Do you have any color?
It's like a brownish color. But it's not a body.
What is it?
It's almost like a... like I'm rubbery. Or something. Like I'm very flexible and rubbery.
How does that feel?
Normal. Like I'm okay like that.
So let's see what happens after you meet with Mother Mary and these little robots. What happens after that?
She's sitting with me.
Mm-hmm. What does she tell you?
She tells me it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter.
What
does Everything it? Was always all right. She's telling me to tell her about my journeys and I'm telling her the stories of everything that's happened to me.
Mm-hmm. In what way do you tell her?
I told her that a family of a gentleman didn't want me for him. I told her about my cousin's wedding. I told her about my marriage. I told her that he passed away. And I told her that the children never grew.
Ask her why the children never grew.
She said they weren't supposed to. She said they were there to help me.
Mm-hmm. What were they helping you with?
My life story.
Mm-hmm.
The little boy and the little girl.
What role do they play in your life, in your life's journey?
They seem to just be there to understand.
Mm-hmm.
And support me. Not judge anything I've done.
Mm-hmm. Ask her if these two children follow you in different lifetimes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
They follow me in everything I do.
Mm-hmm. Who are these children?
They're the ones who came with me here.
Mm-hmm. Ask her where you're from originally. Where did you all come from?
She said, I come from a blue planet.
Mm-hmm.
And the children are from that planet too.
Do these golden robots have anything to do with that planet?
No.
Hmm. What form do you have in that blue planet?
That same rubbery form.
Mm-hmm. As you have now.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Ask Mother Mary where that life as Michelle was. Ask her what planet that was.
Planet Earth.
Planet Earth. Mm-hmm. Does she know what year it was?
1957.
Mm-hmm. Is that the year that Michelle died?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Does Mother Mary have anything else to say?
She tells me I'm not by myself.
Mm-hmm. Ask her what that means.
She said, I have a host
mm-hmm.
of angels with me.
Who are they?
She said they come from every planet to aid me.
Mm-hmm. Ask Mother Mary who she's referring to. Is she referring to Michelle or is she referring to Corrine?
Michelle.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So ask her about these angels.
She said, I know about them.
Do they have names?
Gloria.
Gloria? Mm-hmm. What does Gloria do for Michelle?
She comforts her
mm-hmm.
when Michelle feels lost and down.
Was she there at the beach with her?
Yes.
What else does she say?
She said, I have to be free.
Mm-hmm.
No matter what happens, I have to be free.
When she says free, does she mean free from responsibilities or people?
Free from worry.
Okay.
Free that from thinking that things are not going to be well for me.
Anything else?
No.
Very good. All right, let's close that scene. We'll leave will drift away from that lifetime or leave and leave that life and that woman there to continue on her journey. We'd like to thank Mother Mary for being there today. We're leaving that scene to continue on her own path. And now we're drifting and floating to another lifetime. Another lifetime to find the origin of the fear of enclosed places, of airplanes, of trains, of the expanse of the ocean. We're looking for the origin of that fear. Let me know when you're there. Where are you?
I'm in India.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more. Are you male or female?
I'm a male.
Mm-hmm.
I seem to be some sort of guard.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like my job.
Describe yourself.
I'm in my 30s. I have dark hair, mustache.
Mm-hmm.
I have a white uniform.
Mm-hmm.
Short sleeves.
What are you guarding?
I'm by an ocean again.
Mm-hmm.
I'm guarding certain people from going into the ocean.
Mm-hmm.
It's like there are rich people using the beach area, and I can't let the poor people go to the beach.
Mm-hmm.
That's my job.
And you say you don't like your job?
No.
Tell me why.
Because I want everyone to use the beach. But I have to keep doing this all day long.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens. Tell me what happens in that scene.
I get into an argument with this guy who wants to use the water.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm telling him he can't.
How do you guard this place? Do you have any arms?
No, I'm not armed.
Mm-hmm.
I just have to stand there and watch that only the rich people.
Mm-hmm. So tell me about this argument.
He wants to get into the water, and I'm telling him he cannot. And the argument is escalating. And he hits me with something. But I'm still fighting back.
What happens next?
He knocks me out. I'm laying, he hits me in the head. And I'm bleeding. He runs away.
What happens to you?
I feel like I'm dying. And I'm fearful because I have a family to take care of. Mm-hmm. And I have to be on that job. I'm the only provider.
What happens next?
No one is coming to help me.
What's going through your mind as you're lying there?
How am I going to provide for my family?
Mm-hmm.
I know this is it. I won't be able to do this job anymore. I'm too hurt. I'm still laying there.
So let's fast forward and see what happens.
I'm home.
Mm-hmm.
With my wife and kids. My head is bandaged. My wife keeps asking, what are we gonna do? I have to get back to work. And I know I can't.
Is there anything else from that scene that's important?
The same two children.
Mm-hmm.
The 5-year-old and the 7-year-old.
Mm-hmm.
They're the same exact children.
Do they look the same?
They look the same.
Mm-hmm.
And they understand. They're trying to comfort me.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's close that scene, and now we're moving to another important scene in that lifetime. Be there now.
Yes.
What's happening?
I'm an aide to the leader of India.
Mm-hmm.
It's an important job.
How old do you feel there?
Forty.
Mm-hmm. And what do you...
Content.
You're content. You do like your job there?
I like my job.
Mm-hmm. What do you do as an aide?
I travel with the leader. I advise him, and he respects me.
Tell me more.
I have a nice home. I'm able to provide for my family. And everything is well. Everything is good.
Very good. Where is it that you work?
I work in the palace.
Mm-hmm.
And I just assist the leader wherever he goes. I'm there providing what he needs.
Very good. Is there anything else in that scene that's important? Look around.
He has jewelry that I have to protect.
Mm-hmm.
In the house. And it's just a nice environment. Everyone seems happy. The maids. Everyone working there. Everything is flowing nicely.
Very good. A much better job than you had before.
A much better job.
Good. Let's close that scene now. Let's move forward. Another important scene in that same lifetime. Where are you?
My wife is ill.
Tell me more.
I'm with her in the room. I'm assuring her that she's going to be okay. She doesn't have to be afraid. She's fearful.
What is she afraid of?
She's afraid of dying.
Mm-hmm.
But I know she's not going to die. She's getting good care. She's more fearful of dying than actual real illness.
Mm-hmm. Do you know what's wrong with her?
No.
So what happens next?
She's grateful.
Mm-hmm.
Because I told her that. Because I told her she's gonna be fine.
Mm-hmm.
And it's as if what I've told her made her feel better.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're dancing.
Where are you?
We're in our home. Enjoying music.
Where is this music coming from?
It's an old-fashioned record player of some kind.
Mm-hmm. What does it look like?
This is like a box with a big horn.
Mm-hmm.
It's playing music and we're dancing and everything is just wonderful.
Wonderful. So let's close that scene now. Let's go forward into that lifetime to another time when something important is happening.
We moved into a larger house. I'm well off financially.
Mm-hmm. Who lives in that house with you?
My wife. Mm-hmm. And the two children.
How do they look?
Same children. Mm-hmm. Same children.
Are they still 5 and 7?
They're still 5 and 7. Mm-hmm. And they're playing. They love the new home.
Tell me more.
I'm able to provide everything that my family needs.
Mm-hmm. Where is it that you work now?
I'm still an assistant to the leader.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
And I'm just doing really well. And I'm respected still because of my honesty.
Let's move forward now. Move forward to the last day of your life, that lifetime. Where are you?
I'm at home. I'm eating. And I'm choking on something.
Mm-hmm. What are you choking on?
I'm choking on... It's not a bone. It's more like something thick. Mm-hmm. Like a dumpling or something. Mm-hmm. And it's lodged.
Are you by yourself or are there others with you?
I'm by myself at the table. Mm-hmm. And I can't seem to get help. Because there's no one there. I'm at the dinner table by myself.
What happens next?
I'm sweating. My eyes are bulging.
What thoughts are going through your mind?
That there's nothing I can do mm-hmm. about this. I'm very fearful.
What are you afraid of?
This thing is not coming out of my throat. And I'm thinking everything was so great. And now, no one's going to find me alive. Now I've accepted this. My head is on the table.
What happens next as you transition away from your body?
It's like two people. Mm-hmm. I'm still in uniform. The white uniform that I have on, and I'm watching the other body on the table. Mm-hmm. But I have no emotion about that.
Mm-hmm. When you look at that body on the table, how do you feel?
That it's okay.
Mm-hmm.
That it's okay.
Well, so where do you go?
I'm going up the stairs to the house. I go into a room. My wife is sleeping. It's like I go through the window.
Mm-hmm. So you saw your wife and then you went through the window?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Where did you go after that?
I'm walking towards the blue planet.
Mm-hmm.
It's like that's where I really live.
Mm-hmm. What's this planet made of?
Looks like a big moon.
Mm-hmm.
A big blue moon.
Mm-hmm. As you get closer to this planet, what happens?
The planet itself is talking to me.
Mm. What is
it? Like it's like lights. The lights are going on and off, and it's, I can feel it talking to me.
Mm-hmm. What does it say?
It's saying, "You're back. Good job. Good job."
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just happy.
Mm-hmm.
To be going back.
Where do you go when you go to this planet?
When I go into the planet, I just get absorbed by it.
Mm-hmm. So you merge with the planet?
I merge with it, and then I'm not wearing the white uniform anymore.
Mm-hmm. What are you now?
I'm that brownish, body.
Mm-hmm.
That pliable body.
Mm-hmm. Does it have any form?
It's almost like a gingerbread mm-hmm. type of shape.
Is there anybody with you? Or are you by yourself?
There are a lot of people, but then they're all pliable.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody's busy doing different things.
Does anybody else come to meet you?
No. I come in like normal.
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking for the ones who runs everything.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going straight to the one who is in charge.
Who is it?
It's a pliable person.
Mm-hmm.
Sitting on a big chair.
Mm-hmm. Do they have a face?
They have a shape, but they don't have a face.
Okay.
They don't have any features.
Mm-hmm. So who is this?
He's in charge of the blue planet.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling him that I'm back.
What does he say?
He says he knows that I'm back.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of indifferent, though.
Mm-hmm.
He said he knows that I'm back.
How do you feel being there?
As if I was always there.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost like I went to do a job and now I'm home.
Mm-hmm.
So it's normal. I'm okay to be back.
Mm-hmm.
But he's telling me not to get too comfortable.
Why is that?
Because I have to go back again.
Mm-hmm. What is the reason why you're going back?
He said I have another job to do.
Mm-hmm. Ask him what's the purpose of this job.
He said I have to go and help the others. And bring them back.
Who are the others?
They're pliable people in human form.
Mm-hmm.
And I have to go back to Earth and help them.
How many are there?
12 of them.
Mm-hmm. What is the reason why they are on Earth?
They're on Earth to help. They're on Earth to help the people.
Mm-hmm.
But they're having difficulty helping the people.
Why is that?
The people are not listening. Mm-hmm. So they don't feel effective.
What was the purpose of this, of these blue planet people coming to Earth?
To get the people's minds away from everything material.
Mm-hmm.
To get them to understand that those things are not real. To wake them up from the dream state.
Mm-hmm. Now, did these 12 people volunteer to come to Earth, or were they sent there?
They were sent there.
Mm-hmm. Did they agree to it?
They agreed to it.
Mm-hmm. Is your blue planet of free will?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So they agreed to this. Did they volunteer for it?
They volunteered, but not happily.
Why is that?
Because they were happy being at home.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't want to come out there.
Mm-hmm.
But they couldn't say no either.
Why is that?
Because they know that the job was important.
Mm-hmm.
They know that it was a very important mission.
Mm-hmm. And what is going on with Earth?
The people forgot who they are. We feel sorry for them.
Tell me more.
That's why we went to help. They don't understand.
What do they not understand?
They think the life that they're living is the real one. They forgot who they are. They lost their power.
How did they lose their power?
They absorb all the suggestions of planet Earth. They've allowed the suggestions to take over their lives. And we have to go and change their minds.
How would you do that?
We have to show them how to love.
When you say that they've forgotten who they are, who are they truly?
They are transparent. They're light. But they don't know that.
What powers does this light have?
This light permits them to love. And love is what provides the growth in everything.
Mm-hmm.
They think they're the ones doing the work. And we have to tell them they're not the ones doing the work.
Who is doing the work?
The Divine One. The one who created everything.
Mm-hmm. How do they use the power of the divine?
Us, the blue planet?
Has the humans. You say that they're light and that they think that they're doing things, but it's really the Divine One. How do they get the Divine One to help them?
They have to turn around and face that light. They have to open their eyes and see that light.
Is that light physical?
No, but it can be. They can open their eyes and see that light, that spark of light.
Mm-hmm.
Very powerful spark of light. And they choose not to look at it.
So do they simply need to ask the Divine One to help?
They know they can do that.
Mm-hmm.
But they don't want to. They're too immersed in the suggestions of planet Earth.
Mm-hmm. Now these 12 ones that are on planet Earth, where are they?
They're all over the Earth. They're spread out all over the earth, and they're struggling. They're struggling.
Do they have fears?
No. They have no fears.
Mm-hmm. So why do you say they're struggling?
Because the people are not listening.
Mm-hmm.
And the longer they don't listen, the longer we have to be with them.
How long do these, from your blue planet, how long do they live?
Thousands of years.
Hmm. What do they look like?
No features. Pliable.
Mm-hmm.
Same shape, except some are adult-like.
Mm-hmm.
And some are children-like.
Are the humans able to see them?
No. They're in human form when they come to Earth.
Mm-hmm. So are they born of a human parent?
No.
No.
No, we manifest.
Mm-hmm.
We're not born.
Okay. And are humans are not able to see you?
No. Not in our regular form.
Mm-hmm. So how is it that you affect, for example, the life of Kareem? What does she have to do with the blue planet?
Corinne is one of us. She's in human form. She's here to help. She's one of the ones struggling.
Mm-hmm. Why is it that she has so many fears? Especially fears of enclosed places, airplanes, trains, ships.
She has not adjusted to her body. She has not adjusted to the human form.
How can we eliminate these fears today?
She must face them.
What would you suggest? Kareem traveled 36 hours to be in this session today because of her fears. How can she fight that fear? Eliminate it.
She must become fully present in human form.
Mm-hmm.
She must understand that her fears are not real. She must remember who she is.
What do you call yourselves?
Arcturians.
Arcturians. Mm-hmm. Can you tell me if she has a higher self?
I am her higher self.
Okay. So you can help me with rewiring her mind, her human mind, eliminating this fear.
Yes.
Thank you. Would you explain to her today why she is so fearful of relationships and intimacy? What happened to her to cause this?
She resisted going into human form.
Mm-hmm.
She fought it.
Why is that?
She didn't want to do it. But she knows that it was important.
Mm-hmm. Did she volunteer for that?
She was told she must go.
Okay. Who told her? Does she have a council that does that?
The one in charge.
Okay.
Because she was the only one who could do this job.
Why is that?
Because in human form she would possess all of the necessary emotions
mm-hmm.
to help others. But she still is not comfortable in this human form.
Mm. Can you rewire her so that she can lose that fear?
Absolutely.
Thank you. Why does she experience so much anxiety and sadness? She knows she should be happy, but she's not.
Because she keeps thinking about home.
The blue planet.
She keeps thinking about the blue planet.
Mm-hmm.
And she keeps looking back.
Mm. She's not fully present.
She's not fully present.
Mm-hmm. So what would you like to tell her about that?
It's all right to be fully present. You must be fully present to do this job.
Why does she carry so much guilt? She's guilty about everything.
She was told that that's how she would be effective in the world.
Through guilt?
Through guilt.
Hmm. So she's put it on herself?
Yes.
Does she need to have that guilt?
No.
Can we get rid of that right now?
Absolutely.
Okay. Let's start first with the guilt of her mother's passing. She was calling her. She ignored her, she went to work. Did you tell her about that?
Your mother knows that she was leaving. She was calling you to tell you that she was leaving. You didn't want to hear it. You didn't want to go to her. And so she left.
So does she need to leave, have that guilt anymore?
No.
Okay. Would you remove that from her, please?
Yes.
Thank you. Why did she choose to be a teacher?
She works with the little one in the blue planet.
Mm-hmm.
And she's bringing that knowledge to them.
Mm-hmm. Those little ones that always appeared in all of her lives, the 5 and the 7-year-olds, who were they? And why didn't they change shape and age?
They chose to come and assist the lifetimes on planet Earth, and they decided they would not change shape from lifetime to lifetime.
Is that possible?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why did they not come into this lifetime as Kareen?
They decided to go back.
Okay. I talked about Kareen going back to her, about the children that she's teaching. Why are so many of these children angry?
They don't want to be on Earth.
Where are they from?
They're from various planets.
Mm-hmm. Are these the volunteers that Dolores Cannon spoke about?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What's their mission here?
Their mission is to provide intelligence, but not in the way that earthlings think of intelligence.
Mm-hmm. Not schoolwork.
They're here to teach earthlings how to be free from constraints of the earth that's keeping them down. They need to learn acceptance and non-judgment and love. That's why the children are angry. They want the people of Earth to change their minds.
But instead we medicate them.
But that's okay. They're still going to do their job.
What is their goal eventually as adults, when they get to be adults?
They're going to transform planet Earth into one of unity and cooperation. And they will get the job done.
They will. It seems that there were other waves of volunteers before them that weren't very successful.
The environment was too harsh for them. They longed to go home, and that interfered with their job on planet Earth.
Who were the most successful ones so far?
The ones that are here now will be the most successful ones. Because they're determined. And they're not fearful of anything.
It seems that the ones that are around 20s and down seem to be less fearful.
They're very militant.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not afraid of humans.
Okay. And are they coming from every planet around?
They're coming from every planet, but they have the same mission.
Mm-hmm.
To help the Earth. Because the Earthlings cannot do it.
Mm-hmm.
They're too. They're too immersed. In the sleep, they are mesmerized by the things of the earth, and they can't awake from that, but they're going to.
It seems some are already waking up.
Many are waking up. And every time they wake up, there are more lights in the planets. The planets become brighter. And that's a sign of that they're succeeding on planet Earth. For every human that wakes. The planets light up.
This planet, or all of them?
All of those from all the planets who have come to planet Earth to assist. Every Earthling that wakes up, all of the planets brighten because of the cooperation.
That's awesome. Should Corrine open up a school for these children? Or is she okay where she is?
Corrine was supposed to open her school a long time ago. Corrine is allowing doubt. To stop her from doing her job.
So what would you like to tell her about that? Seems very important.
Corrine, your school is already there, dear one. It's waiting for your presence. The children are waiting for you. To give them what you came to give them. You must do your job. You must do your job. They're waiting for you.
She says that when she was younger, she remembers that she was afraid that her heart would stop. Why is that?
When she came here, she was unhappy. She knows she had to come, but she was not happy. And in trying to adjust in the body, she kept wondering, was her heart adjusted properly? She kept asking herself, this heart that she will need to get her through. Is it adjusted properly? She was concerned about that.
Mm-hmm. What's happening now with this fluttering that she has in her chest area, her chest throat area?
She has work to do.
What does that fluttering mean? Because I have it too.
The fluttering is an energy that seems to be blocked in that area.
What's causing that?
Clarence. The body is cleansing itself. This energy came from way down. It's making her way out of her system. But she must not be fearful. She must allow it to release itself.
Does this energy have anything to do with, like, the Kundalini awakening?
Yes.
So she's in the process of releasing it?
She's in the process of releasing.
Now, you said she shouldn't be fearful of it. What will she feel as it awakens and releases?
She will feel dizziness. She will feel weakness. She will feel sadness. She will feel confusion. But it's all for the good. She must not be fearful.
Why does she feel this sadness? What causes that?
The sadness is accumulated energy. It's negative energy somehow that is trapped in the body. But she's being worked on to release all of those things. And she's afraid. But she must not be afraid.
Is there anything that I can do to help her release this energy?
Speak to it. Tell it not to be afraid.
Where is this energy trapped?
In her throat.
In her throat.
Area.
All right, so I'm going to take my hand over her throat area now. And I'm going to ask for this energy to express itself. Good evening, brother.
Yes.
How can I help you here tonight?
I don't want you to help me. I'm safe where I am.
How long have you been there?
Very, very long time. Since before birth.
Since before birth. What attracted you to this being?
Fear.
Fear. Was it brought on by her mother?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why was it that you were brought to her? Why her?
I want to protect her.
Mm-hmm. Did you know her in a different life?
Yes.
How were you connected with her?
I was her child.
Mm-hmm. What year was that?
1936.
Mm-hmm. What country were you in?
Indonesia.
Indonesia. And how old are you?
4.
Mm-hmm. What is your name?
Maria.
Maria. So you're a little girl.
I'm a little girl.
Mm-hmm. Maria, how is it that you died? What happened to you?
My mother didn't want me.
Mm-hmm. Is this the same mother that you have now? That you're in now? The same soul?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what happened?
She aborted me.
Mm-hmm.
And I hid myself.
Where did you hide?
In her.
In her throat?
In her body.
In her body. And this was in the 30s?
1936.
1936. So you said you were 4 years old. Is that the age that you choose to be?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why 4?
It's my 4th lifetime.
Have you been with her all of these lifetimes?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So where are you from, Maria? Where do you originate from? Are you from the blue planet also?
No.
No? Where are you from?
I'm not from a planet. I'm not from anywhere. I'm just from a dark place.
Oh, from a dark place. Okay.
I live in darkness.
I see. But Maria, even if you live in darkness, you all came from the same divine light. I want you to look inside of you, Maria, and look for that spark of light that's inside of you. It may be very light, but it's there. Take a look. Do you see it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I want you to expand that light out, Maria. Expand it into your whole body. Fill yourself with that light. How does that feel?
Safe.
Mm-hmm. There's no fear there, is there?
No.
Mm-hmm. Maria, would you like to go back to the light now? And break this contract?
Yes.
Okay. So, Maria, I'm going to put my hand on top of your mom's chest and connect with you there. And when I do, I want you to release all of those feelings that you had all of these times that you were aborted, that you didn't feel safe. Release all of that to me. And I want you to pull from every cell of this woman's body, every ligament, every muscle in her physical body, astral body, all the bodies that she has, pull out all of your cords, all of your connections from her. Pull them all out. And as you pull them out, give me all of those feelings that you had. And tell me when everything is empty and you've pulled everything from her. I'm going to take that now and send it off into the universe for healing, Maria. You no longer have those feelings. Now, in that space that's left, what would you like to fill that with?
Light and love.
I'm going to fill it with light and love, and I'm going to touch your forehead and seal that. What else would you like to fill it with?
Confidence and joy.
Lots of confidence and joy, and I'm going to seal that. What else?
Faith.
Lots of faith. Let's fill that space. How does that feel now, Maria?
Wonderful.
Mm-hmm. Do you forgive your mother for aborting you? For not wanting you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Tell her what you feel.
I forgive you. You were fearful.
Mm-hmm. And now I'm going... Mm-hmm. What else?
Goodbye.
Goodbye. And before you go, Maria, I'm going to have Kareem. I'm going to touch her forehead and ask Kareem to tell you how she feels about you leaving her. What would you like to tell Maria in passing?
I am love, and you are love. And I loved you, even though I had to do the separation.
Do you forgive yourself for that?
Yes.
I'm going to put my hand on your chest and I want you to give me all of that. All of those feelings that you had. Give them all to me now. All of the times you've had to separate from Maria and from all the others. Give it all to me. You don't need that anymore. Tell me when you've released all of it. Taking all of that. Now, Kareem, what would you like to fill that with?
Love.
Mm-hmm. Let's fill it with love.
Peace.
Seal it. Mm-hmm. Lots of peace.
Contentment.
Mm-hmm. Contentment.
Strength.
Mm-hmm. Strength. How does that feel?
Wonderful.
Okay, so let me speak with Maria again. Maria, I want you to find your way out through the crown of her head, and I want you to pull all of those cords that were connected to this lifetime and all of the other lifetimes she's ever lived with you. Pull that from all of those locations, all those four lifetimes. Pull them out. And I want you to go straight to the light and tell me when you get there.
I'm there.
Wonderful. Now, Maria, I'd like you for you, since you're in the light, I want you to fill her entire body with that loving light. fill her, all that space where you were residing, fill her with that light. Heal her. Tell me when you're done.
I'm done.
Thank you, Maria. May the light of the universe accompany you with lots of love.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And let me speak now with the higher self again.
Yes.
How does her body look now?
Radiant.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Would you do a body scan and see if there's anything else that we need to work on today? She's fine. Wonderful. Would you put some energy into her lower back that sometimes flares up on her?
Yes.
In her left arm? And give her some tips as to what she should do about that arm that she tends to irritate with the heavy load?
She must begin an exercise regimen that she must do continuously. She must not focus so much on the arm.
What should she focus on?
On being happy. But she must continue to exercise.
Good. How is her diet? Is it good?
She has a good diet. She's very careful with her diet.
Good.
She needs to drink more water.
What else? Anything? Or is she good?
She's good.
Good. One question that I didn't ask is about her spirit guide. Who's the one who guides her?
Mother Mary.
Mother Mary. Wonderful. Good. So when she said the Hail Mary when she was younger and that she felt that protection, that was Mother Mary?
Yes.
Okay. Is there anybody else who protects her?
Michael.
Great. I guess that Michael brought her down to see me?
Michael led her, yeah.
Love Michael. Can he help also with her fear of flying so that she can travel more often?
Michael will lead her on a plane.
Okay, great. That's wonderful. Is there anything that I haven't asked that I could have asked that she should know about? Or is there a final message for her?
Do not allow yourself to think of loneliness. Do not allow yourself to worry. You must find a way to avoid those things because they slow down your vibration. You must focus on love whenever anything arises. Love it. Send love to it. And it will raise your vibration. That you must remember to do.
Wonderful. Do you have a message for anyone else, myself, or anyone who would be watching?
You're doing the work, Alba. You're doing what you came here to do. For everyone that you help, the light shines in your planet. For everyone who comes to you,
thank you.
Thank you.
I'm at a crossroads right now whether I should be doing this full time. Any suggestions?
This is what you must do. And in time, it will become full time. Mm-hmm. It will become your work, your life's work. Because so many are waiting for your guidance and assistance.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Wide awake. Wide awake. Feeling wonderful all over. Welcome back.
Oh my goodness.
Tell me, how are you feeling?
I feel like I was really away. I really feel like I was away somewhere.
And how did it feel?
It was odd. Like I was watching a movie or something. But it was me out there.
So you were watching the movie and you were you also?
Yes. And I was feeling what was going on. I remember in that party I had that red dress with my cousin's wedding.
Yes.
But I can feel when I was being talked about, like, and I can feel the gentleman who was, who can approach me. Wow.
How long do you feel that you were on this little journey?
About an hour and a half, an hour?
Two plus.
Wow.
Right now we're on 211. Wow. You did great. Fantastic.
Really, that's weird.
How do you feel?
Like I'm here, but I felt like I traveled.
Pretty wild about this blue planet, huh?
Isn't that something? It's right. As if I was there.
You have a mission.
Getting orders.
You have a really important mission.
I can remember when I left in that white uniform, and I went straight, that planet was like waiting or something.
It was alive.
Yes, and I just immersed, went through it. But when I went through it, I was that wiry.
Like rubbery thing?
Yeah, and everybody, it was normal. to be there. But I couldn't stay. I had to.
Yeah, you were sent back. I was apparently going to be sent back. You have a really important mission. So now, does everything make sense?
Everything makes sense.
Mm-hmm. This was an incredible session. I mean, mind-blowing.
Oh. I'm grateful.
Was it worth the 38 hours? How many? 36?
36 hours.
36 hours on a bus?
Absolutely, yes. Very, very much so. Hmm.
So do you want to share this? This is wild. This had everything. I mean, every topic. It was just amazing.
I'm kind of, I don't know if I should share it.
It talks about volunteers. It talks about the new people. It's amazing. It really talks about how every time you help somebody, it lights up all the planets. It's just an amazing.
And I was so sure about that.
Oh yeah.
Like, for everyone that you help here,
It lights up.
Everything lights up. Like,
this had a very important message to everybody. Really important. It wasn't about you almost. It was about the volunteers that are here. Because you're a light worker. You're a volunteer to be here. And there's a lot of light workers out there also doing the same job. And this is almost like a confirmation that, yeah, they're supposed to be here and they're doing their job.
To me, yes.
It was amazing to me. I was getting goosebumps and...
Wow. Blue planet.
Mm-hmm. How did it feel with Maria?
It was like I saw a little kid crouched, like crouched somewhere, and who's just been there so long.
Yeah.
And she received like recognition or something.
Mm-hmm.
But I can see her like a little kid with boots and a little white top.
Mm-hmm. Did you feel anything through your body as she was releasing?
I felt like it was almost like she was spreading this glitter, almost like moving her arm all over me. But then I felt my body was like a wave.
Wow.
Like when she was doing that, like a wave, like, but she was just spreading all of this glittery thing over me.
Amazing. You know, while I'm having this session to me with you today, you know, I'm thinking to myself, this was so worth it. This was so worth it. I mean,
it really was.
It really was so worth it.
No, but when I open my eyes, it's so weird. Like, it's almost like like my spirit left or something, and then I came back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you were kind of gone, but really...
Yeah.
Yeah, like in two different places. So what do you think? Yes? No?
All right. Okay.
That's great. I appreciate it because I think a lot of people would learn. That's how you found me, for God's sakes.
And now I just had this thought that everyone, this might help someone.
Yes, it would. It would. Okay. Yes. Okay. So here we are in Miami, Florida, and Corrine has come here from a long way. Let's get together here so at least we're together.
We're together? Yay! Let me turn the light on. Much better. So here we are, Miami, Florida, and we had a great session. Great session. And if you would like to have a session like this, go to my website, albaweinman.com, sign up, and we'll see each other. Okay, so thank you for watching, and until the next time, bye.